Well, if you're involved in a crash, you might not be able to work, making things tight for your family, especially if your insurance denies paying those lost wages. But there could be a solution out there. Attorney Tom Sinas joining us now to tell us how Michigan's no-fault laws and wage recovery can help you out in time of crisis.
You know, we talk a lot about the no-fault law sure. and the medical component.
Right, sure.
And as we hear the subject of no-fault in the news again, I think we're going to hear more and more
for
about
sure.
the medical component. But one of the things that we forget is the thing that can be almost equally valuable, especially in the initial phases of what someone is going through after
yeah,
a crash.
Your ability to not work, inability
that's
to
right,
work.
The economic loss from the inability to work. So how does our system work? We have, in cases where someone is injured but survives and cannot go back to work, that person is entitled to receive what we call work loss benefits.
Mm-hmm.
And they get these benefits from their own auto insurance company.
Okay.
This is part of our no-fault system. What kind of benefits can they get? Well, the general rule is they can get 85% of their pre-crash gross wages.
Okay.
But that amount is subject to a monthly cap set by the legislature. And right now, that cap is around $5,700 a month. So for some folks who are high wage earners, they may be losing income from
sure.
day one, even though they're getting wage loss benefits.
Sure, it's not as much as they normally would be.
Well, how long does the wage loss benefit go? It only goes for 3 years.
Okay.
So for those first 3 years, you're getting your lost wages from your no-fault insurer. What if, heaven forbid, after 3 years you can't return to work? Well, your only remedy to recover those lost wages is to pursue a claim against the person who caused the accident.
Okay.
Okay, we call that the at-fault driver. Now, these concepts also apply in cases involving death. In cases involving death, we call the benefits survivor's loss. Survivor's loss benefits are payable to the dependents
sure.
of the person who died. And those dependents are allowed to be paid that same monthly maximum benefit, can't exceed that amount, and it's designed to replace the deceased's lost wages, lost fringe benefits, and other what we call tangible things of economic value. In other words, it's designed to fill the hole, financial hole,
sure.
that's created by someone's passing.
Even if they had a life insurance policy, they're still eligible to get those.
That's exactly right.
Okay.
That's a very good point. They're not mutually exclusive, or they are mutually exclusive. They do not depend on one another. But again, what happens after 3 years of someone passing? If there's continued economic loss that the family's experiencing, that family's only remedy is to pursue a claim against the person who caused the accident.
Mm-hmm.
Now, of course, if the deceased is the person who caused the accident, then the financial loss benefits end at 3 years. So what we have in our no-fault system is something that I think we need to remember as we talk about it, which is that we have this three-year mm-hmm. safety period of wage replacement in cases of serious injury and death.
Certainly important stuff. People have questions about it. Could be a real big issue. Where do they find you?
They can find us online at www.sinasdramus.com. They can give us a call in West Michigan at 616-301-3333 or shoot us an email at info@sinasdramus.com.
Right, thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Derek.